Hello, Arthur.
Hello.
I thought that was you sitting here.
Yeah.
Not looking too good, guy.
I'm sick. Hey, what's happening, C?
Hey, Joe, how you doing?
What's going on, man?
I'm gonna take this guy in and get him something to eat.
Oh, man, don't worry about him. He a bum. Leave him there, man. That's where he belongs.
Oh, I gotta help him out. How would you like to be sitting out here? You get this guy something to eat and keep him off the brew.
He always brings these bums in here. I don't know. I'm not saying that I'll divorce him, but I've had it. Look. I'm ready to leave him if I have to. Wait a minute. Is it Cecil?
It is.
And his friend, Joe Cleveland. 6 months ago, he wouldn't be caught dead with someone like that.
Sorry.
Where's all the glasses?
Where do you think?
Well, I'll wash up a couple and pour some drinks, okay?
I'll fix you some drinks.
Go in the other room, Joe. Hey, what are you doing over there?
I'm dumping this poison down the sink. I should have done it a long time ago.
Hey! You just poured my best friend down the drain.
Your best friend just cost you your marriage. Come on, Cecil. I think we ought to take a little walk. Come on, outside. Come on, hold on now. You don't want to do anything rash.
Hey, she can't leave me.
Oh, yes, she can. Mom, I'm leaving her. Tomorrow morning. I'm taking the children, too.
Good, man. I'll talk to you later.
I get to the point where I hate you.
I know, Jane. I went through the same thing.
But Sharon, your husband never did this. He doesn't even sleep at home at night sometimes. He doesn't have any care for his children. You see the way that he treats me? There's not an ounce of decency left in him anymore. I can't stand it anymore, Sharon. I've got to go.
You sure he's not going to pull something like
that? I don't know,
again.
Sharon. I'll be out of here in the morning.
Are you sure you don't want me to stick around just in case?
I'm leaving. I'm taking him with me. There's nothing you can do.
Cecil, he's sick. You can't take
him. Get out of my way.
Dad, where are we going?
We're going to Grandma's. Go back to sleep, honey. It's okay.
Never been like this before. What's wrong with you?
Get up now.
Hey, Joe. Let me in. Cease.
Hey, what's the matter? Your boy sick?
No, I am.
Come on in. Why don't you have a seat? Stuff here is all I got.
No, I don't need that. Gene's gonna leave me in the morning, and I think I'm gonna kill myself.
What? Oh, man. Why you so uptight, man? Your woman wanna leave, you let her go.
I can't do that, Joe. She's all I got.
But you need a place to stay?
No, no. I need some help. I need some real help.
Oh, man. Look here, man. We done been through all this stuff before. You can't quit drinking. So why don't you just accept it? That's the only way you're gonna ever be happy.
No. There's gotta be some other way. Where's your phone book?
A what?
Yellow Pages, phone book.
There you go. What you doing?
Got one. You watch Ronnie until I come back. Make sure he don't catch a cold.
Yeah, I'll look out for him, but, Hey, man, what you doing, man? Calling some preacher you don't even know at 4 o'clock in the morning.
It's my only hope.
Hello?
Hello, Reverend Baird.
This is Reverend Baird.
I hate to call you at this late hour, but I'm an alcoholic, and I'm thinking about killing myself.
But I'm afraid to die.
Do you know how to get here?
I'll find it.
Okay, I'll see you in a few minutes.
Who was that, dear?
Oh, some guy named Help. I'm glad to meet you, Cecil. You can just call me Tom. Come on in. Just go ahead and sit down and we can talk.
I don't know where to start.
Well, let's start from the beginning.
I've been drinking on and off now for about 12 years, I guess.
Well, how'd you get started?
How did I start drinking?
Mm-hmm.
When I was 13, that's when everything started going wrong for me. You see, up until then, I was happy. And then one day, I was riding my horse Peanuts.
I'm sorry, Clift. I'm afraid she'll never make it.
Dear God, please don't let her die. God, she's all I got.
Cecil, this is Myrna. She's going to be taking care of your mother for a while.
Hello, Cecil.
I'll let the two of you stay here and get acquainted, and I'll carry the bags on you.
You mean to say you're 13 and you can't carry more than one of those at a time?
To invite Myrna. You know I already hate her.
Now, Cecil, you know the Bible says we're not supposed to hate anybody.
Yeah, but wasn't the Bible written before Myrna was ever born?
Who you are.
She should. She's my mom.
Let's just move you over here by the window, Julia, so you can watch the cars go by. I can't work with you in here. Go out and milk the cows or something.
You're not my mother.
You're acting like a little baby. Now, don't you see you're upsetting her? Now, get out, now. You're just making things worse. Now, Julia, feeding time. Now let's open our mouth. Julia, you're impossible. There's a lot of things I'd rather be doing right now than trying to get you to open your mouth. Why, you? It's been very hard for you these days, hasn't it, Cliff?
Really has. But you know, the Lord gives and the Lord takes away. And I've certainly appreciated your concern.
Well, maybe one of these days, Julia will get better. I certainly hope so. You know, the children so desperately need a mother. I'd like to stay just as long as you'd like me to, Cliff.
Julie'd be alive today.
Why, his birth alone wore poor Julie out.
He's carrying on ever since. He's been wearing her out all the time.
Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Receive you unto myself.
Dad?
What is it, Cecil?
Is Myrna going to be living here for good?
For a while, Cecil.
Well, Peanuts, she's gone. Remember the other day when I came home and told you she was getting better? Well, I thought she was. I'll tell you one thing, Peanuts. I'm sure glad I got you. You may not be the best looking horse in the world, but when you're feeling good, you and I can outrun anybody.
Jackie.
What? That squirrel?
Well, the noses are alike. And the teeth.
Oh. Cecil. Did Dad tell you?
Tell me what?
He and Myrna are getting married.
Tell me you're kidding. Boy, I sure ain't looking forward to going home today.
Why not?
Myrna's home from the honeymoon with Dad. She thinks she's boss now. She won't even let me play piano.
Listen. If things get too rough, you can always run. That's what I did.
You did? Well, I'll see you, okay?
Yeah.
Hello, Cecil.
Hi.
I've told you about your shoes. How was school today, Cecil?
Okay.
Cecil, this is my mother, Phyllis. She'll be staying with us for a while. You can call her Grandma if you'd like.
Hi.
Hi what?
Hi, Phyllis.
It's a pleasure to know you, Cecil. Have you heard any news about Cliff yet?
Yes, Mother. I called the hospital and they said that Cliff would be coming home tomorrow if things go well.
Oh, wonderful. Betty, how are you doing in school?
Oh, haven't you heard?
Heard what, Betty?
I was accepted to nursing school last week. I'll be starting next summer after I graduate.
Nursing school. Is that so? Following in your mother's footsteps, right, dear?
Yes, we're so proud of her. You know, Mother, Betty needs a new dress for graduation.
Well, why don't we all go shopping together for one? How does that sound?
Fine.
I saw something that was just the thing. It had a beautiful sweetheart neckline on it.
Oh, that sounds delightful.
Excuse me.
Ask.
May I please be excused?
I know where he should be.
Where's that?
Beaverton or St. Mary's. They'd instill some discipline in him.
Well, he sure needs something. You know, today I saw him running those milk cows again, and he still hasn't changed the straw in the barn.
Sounds like a good-for-nothing. I don't understand him.
Oh, I don't want to understand him. What do you expect from a boy whose best friend is his horse?
He needs a good beating, if you ask me.
Don't worry. I'll get rid of him.
Well, Peanuts, it's another sad day today. Things are just getting worse and worse. You know, I feel like I'm a big zero. I'm sure I'm not gonna make it like Betty is. Nobody cares, Peanuts. Oh, you still do? Thanks. You know, if I do run away, I'm taking you with. What would you do without me, Peanuts? You'd probably be in a glue bottle by now, wouldn't you?
You little brat. What do you think you're doing coming in here in the middle of the night waking me up? Well, your father's in the hospital. No wonder he's sick. It's things like this that made Cliff sick.
Don't let you
know. Like this
don't
that made
get your hands
father
up.
Sick.
Why, you...
I'm going to lock you in. You can just stay down there and think about everything.
I'll get you for this, Myrna. You just wait and see.
I'll get you, too.
Why isn't Dad here? She'll be sorry she pulled this one on me.
Boy.
Are you Cliff Moore's boy?
I was.
Where are you headed?
I don't know. Just leaving home, I guess.
What's the matter, son?
My stepmother threw me out of the house.
Can you drive a caterpillar?
A caterpillar? I was raised on a cat seat.
Well, I got 1,000 acres of grain that's got to be harvested. How does $5 a day sound to you?
$5 a day?
Follow me down to that ranch at the end of this here road.
My dad didn't seem to mind my leaving home. At least he let me stay with the Hodges. Guess he knew the work would be good for me.
Well, did you work hard?
Yeah, I worked 18 hours a day, 7 days a week. I thought I could buy myself a cattle ranch with the money I was making, and all the months I worked there, I never saved a nickel, spent every bit of it.
Where did you go from there?
Other farms until the war broke out, and then my father signed me up for the Navy.
Seaman First Class Cecil Mull and Seaman First Class Gus Adams report to the duty officer with your gear tomorrow at 1800 hours.
They just said our names. We're going to be shipped out, Gus.
Oh, so well, we'll get shipped.
You don't care?
Well, look what we got to look forward to.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Oh, by the way, this is on your bunk.
Oh, yeah?
Sure.
That's a letter from my dad. Dear Cecil, getting the alfalfa crop in. And Peanuts is okay. Peanuts, that's my horse. I want you to not worry about things because in case something would happen to me, I've got 2 insurance policies. One for you and one for Betty.
Hello?
Hello, Dad.
Oh, Cecil. Good to hear from you.
Dad, are you okay? I just got that letter that you sent me about the insurance policies.
No, don't worry about me. I'm fine.
Well, I'm getting shipped out, and I was
hoping that maybe you and Betty could fly up here and spend a couple of days here.
That sounds terrific, Cecil.
Dad, there's one more thing.
What's that?
Don't bring money. Can you promise me that?
Yes, Cecil, I'll promise you.
Call as soon as you get to the base, and I'll meet you at the Grand Hotel, okay?
Sounds fine.
What did he want? Some more money?
No, he wanted me to come see him at the base for a few days.
Well, you must be disappointed.
I've got to go. It may be the last time I see him.
Well, you didn't tell him that you were coming, did you?
Myrna.
Well, you can't go, Cliff. Your heart condition.
I don't want to talk about it. He's my son. Please.
Your son? Why, I'll tell you, you'll never get there. I'll make sure you don't go. You'll be a cripple before you get down there.
Mr. Moe.
Cecil was right.
My father never did make it out to the base to visit me. His health just got worse, and he died the same summer, 1942.
In my father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. If the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness. For his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies.
What's the matter, Cease?
my father's funeral. Just can't get those preacher's words out of my head. Let not your heart be troubled. My life is ruined. Let me ask you something, Gus. When you drink, does it make you feel good?
Yeah, I guess so.
How does it make you feel?
Well, it makes me forget most of my problems. I don't miss my wife or kids.
So do me a favor.
What's this for?
You know, pick me up a bottle of whiskey.
Are you crazy? You don't drink, C's. I'm not going to be the one to start you off on this.
Look, I really need you to do that for me, okay? Just be a friend.
It's the best I can do for a buck.
This stuff's going to make me go blind, but I'm going to drink it anyway.
Well, that was all it took to start me drinking. Things really weren't too bad then. On weekends, I'd been visiting a girl named Jean. She was a pretty special lady. And with a lot of persuasion, I finally talked her into marrying me. At first, she put up with my drinking because I guess maybe I did it without her knowing. Yeah, but then I could tell Jean changed, and all the time my drinking got worse. I remember how I'd come home and I'd just look for something to get mad at so I'd have an excuse to leave. And believe me, I'd always find a reason to get out of there.
Hey, what's to eat around here?
Why don't you go to the store and get something?
I sent you to the store last week, didn't I?
Well, how long do you think $5 worth of groceries is going to last anyway, Cecil?
As long as it takes you to spend on this kind of slop.
Ronnie, pass the bean cakes, please.
Dad, don't you want some more of these? I haven't got anything on the plate.
It's okay, son. You eat them up. They're good for you.
Take your
These bean cakes are too salty.
Gene, we gotta start having a plan around here. Things are too chaotic. For one thing, we ought to have a menu. White navy beans for breakfast and fish on Friday.
I thought you didn't like beans.
I never said that. All I said was I didn't like them in pancake batter. Another thing is we ought to get these kids' clothes clean every week. I could stand shirt.
Listen,
like
you run the Navy, not me. Now, I'm not going to have a plan of action in my house. I'm going to run my house the way I want to. You can go out and ruin your life the way you want to, but
hey,
don't tell me about
hey,
my house.
I can't stand your complaining.
I complain.
I'm getting out of here. I'm going to go get a square meal.
Don't your wife feed you at home?
Yeah, that's right.
You clumsy idiot, you.
Ma'am?
What do you want?
The soup. I spilled it.
You drunks? You're all like
a bunch of slabs. Right, Lily?
Right.
You know where that music is coming from?
Well, it sure ain't coming from here.
He's coming from right over there.
At this time, my little girl Naomi would like to sing a song to you again. Naomi? David's going to say John 3:16, the golden...
Put out that cigarette, you bum.
Nice and loud now, so everyone hears it.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have eternal life. What God has done for me, he can also do for you. And that the most truthful thing that I've learned in this life is that Jesus loves me because the Bible tells me so.
Amen. And, you've heard the gospel tonight, you've heard the music, and there's no reason that everyone in here can't get saved. Reverend Clark, would you like to come down? And those of you that would like to come to the prayer room, it's over here. Reverend Clark will greet you and go into the prayer room. Eternity is forever, but life is going by so fast, this may be the last time you'll ever hear the word of God again. Keep coming, please. I feel there's someone in the audience yet that you're so close to accepting Christ, but you're so far away. Think of the love of God and think of the life you can have in Christ Jesus. Don't leave here tonight without Christ.
Church.
To church?
Yeah, I have. And then I went to
the tavern.
Yeah, how'd you know?
How many drinks did you have?
Two.
You tell me how a man can get drunk on two drinks?
Now what did I do?
Well, it's not easy. I'll teach you sometime.
You know, Cecil, you need help. I mean, you really need help.
Help? About what?
Your drinking problem. You come home drunk every night and... Would you turn that thing off, please? We don't have any food. We don't have any money. Why can't you quit?
Jean, I could quit if I wanted to, but I like to drink. You ought to come down to the bar. There's some nice people in the tavern.
Why don't you get a babysitter tomorrow night, and you can come down to the tavern with me. You'll like the atmosphere.
But, Cecil, I don't like taverns. I even feel dirty when you're inside of one.
I wouldn't have to go to the tavern if you'd stock up on some beer in the house.
Oh, hi, Jean. Sharon. What you getting all that booze for? You're going to start your own bar?
No.
Seriously, is that for Cecil?
Well, he said he wouldn't have to go to the tavern so much if I kept some beer around the house, so here we are.
Oh, Jean, why do you put up with Cecil's drinking?
Oh, you know how Cecil is, what a tender guy he is, and heck, he never forgets my birthday, and sometimes he even brings me flowers.
Flowers? What about groceries? Who's paying for your Thanksgiving feast,
I
then?
Am. It'll be okay. I've got a part-time job now.
Well, then I'll talk to you tomorrow, Sharon. Happy Thanksgiving.
You walking home?
Well, you know how Cecil is.
Come on, let me give you a ride.
Okay.
Now.
Well, we'll just wait a few more minutes for Daddy. Stan, would you like us at the table?
Okay.
Come on. Ren, you can help, too. Here you go.
Mom, I thought you said that Dad was going to be back in a few minutes.
Well, he probably just got a flat tire.
Y'all have to eat.
Turkey and gravy.
Cranberry sauce. Corn on the cob. And some milk.
You're going to get a pot like your dad if you don't be careful.
Go, 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 Lenny.
Wow, what a game.
Who's winning? Roddy? Here, honey, drink this.
you happen to see your son out there? Ronnie's out in the kitchen right now, and he smells like a brewery. Did you hear me, Cecil? Listen, you can sit there with your life in shambles, but you're not going to risk the life of your children. Do you hear what I'm saying to you, Cecil? Now, I'm not going to take this from you any longer. Something's got to be done. Now, one of us has got to go. Now, which is it going to be, you or me? Will you answer me?
Alice looks very concerned. I don't think the bears are going to recover from this one.
You know, I've been married to you so long that that sounds logical. Would you mind stop rehearsing long enough to jiggle me some dinner? You better make a scramble egg.
Cecil, glad you could come over.
Hi, George. Gee, let's blow out of here.
Come in, Cecil.
Come on.
I'll let you up. Now, wait a minute. Who do you think you are coming in here smiling like a Cheshire cat? There's a lot of things we have to talk about before I go anywhere.
What's the problem?
You've got to stop your drinking. For good.
Jean, I'm turning it off and on like a tap.
Cecil, level with me.
Okay.
Do you promise never to touch another drop of alcohol?
Yeah, not a drop.
No more liquor stores?
No liquor stores. No nothing.
No more bars?
Yeah, bars too. I'll stay out.
All right. Everything settled?
Yeah. I'm gonna let her come back.
Good.
I got something for you, Jean.
Jean, isn't that nice? You know, you didn't have to buy me anything just because you feel guilty.
I don't feel guilty. I just wanted to get something nice for you, Jean. Things started to go really well for me for a while. I actually began to think my drinking days were over. I finished roofing jobs that had been hanging over my head for months. I began to spend more time with the kids, and Jean and I were getting along better than we ever had before.
Now listen, I want you guys to be especially good today, okay? Because this is gonna be a real special day. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Uh-oh.
There's Daddy!
Yeah, now listen, okay, you guys go on out and go meet Dad by the car and then come right back.
Do
right, come on, stand over here and let Daddy sit down. Come on, Cecil, keep your eyes closed now. All right, you guys, are you ready, set, surprise!
Here, Daddy, read the card.
Go ahead.
Honey, I'm so proud of your achievement. I knew you could do it. Love, Jane. You guys care about me a lot.
That's right.
Wow.
If you want to get to that job in Parkland tomorrow, you better get some gas in the car. You've only got 10 minutes left before Joel's closes.
I hate to leave the party when we're just starting to have so much fun.
Don't worry, we'll save some cake for you, won't we, boys?
Yeah!
Cecil! You forgot your coat. Here's some cake for Joe.
Darn, I missed it by 5 minutes.
Long time no see.
Long time no see, so. So how you been?
No, I'm not here to drink. Just came by to pay the money I owe you.
Oh, come on.
Come on, let me have a good sign.
Hey, I'm not worried about the $8. I'm glad you're in the wagon. You're looking good,
fella. Well, Cecil Moe, you old hound dog. What you been up to, fella? No good?
I've been behaving myself.
Oh, yeah? Well, I have. Hey, Harry.
Hey,
here's Cecil, the usual. Fella.
What's the matter? You too good for us now?
Aren't you gonna let us give you a little hospitality?
Don't make us feel guilty. Just one drink. One's not gonna hurt you.
Come on, Cecil, drink.
One's not gonna hurt you.
Don't make us feel guilty. One drink won't hurt you.
It's looking strange. There you go.
Oh, you don't know how good it feels to have Cecil sober again. You know, he hasn't had a drink since Thanksgiving. In fact, we had a little celebration for him here tonight. Well, he had to get some gas. He probably stopped over at Bill and Lola's house on the way home. But frankly, I'm getting just a little bit worried about him now.
Mom, you want me to make you some hot chocolate?
No, Ronnie, dear. Now, you know you ought to be in bed. Now, come on. Listen, Sharon, can you hang on for just a minute? Okay, fine. Hold on. Come on. That's it. Time for bed, and you know it.
Mom, I thought we were going to have another party.
Well, we were, honey, but...
Mom, where's Dad?
Well, he probably went out with some of his friends. You know how Daddy is.
Want some cake, Harry?
No, thanks. One of your kids had a birthday?
No. They baked this cake for me to celebrate my stop drinking.
Ah, come on, Cecil. You're taking things too serious.
Let me ask you something, Joe.
Hey, ask. What is it?
You believe in God?
What?
You think about God, I mean, do you believe he's up there?
Hey, Mo, this ain't a place to be talking about no religion.
You believe in hell?
Yeah, I believe in hell. I'm going through it right now.
I understand what I meant.
Hey, look, man, you want to discuss all them heavy issues? Find yourself somebody else to talk to, okay? Because personally, Mo, I don't care.
Yes, this is the Moe residence.
Mrs. Moe?
Yes, this is Mrs. Moe.
We have your husband, then.
Cecil, is he all right?
We've sent two officers out to your house. They'll be there shortly.
Is this your husband?
Yes.
Does he live here?
Yes.
Hi, honey. I'm home.
Oh, Cecil, at least you could wait till you get to your bed to collapse.
I thought I was there already.
You know how much you've upset the children? Do you know that the kids were waiting for you? They waited for you with the cake for 3 hours. They were.
Get off my back. It's not my fault you had that party. About that silly cake and stupid shirt. Who wants that party for a stinking drunk anyway?
He missed the party. He doesn't love me. He doesn't love any of us.
Give him some Alka-Seltzer. He's probably got indigestion.
Be dead, then he'll be sorry.
Oh, it'll be all right, honey. You're probably just having a nightmare.
A kid just like him is not even a fruitcake.
You're not helping things.
Better.
Get away, you stink, you pig. Go take a bath.
It's not my style. I'm sorry, Jean. I know you're upset about tonight.
Look what this is doing to the kids. Ronnie's never been like this before. What's wrong with you, Cecil? You go out and you drink up all your money and you come back here and you throw it all up again. What's wrong with you?
I don't know. I think I got a problem.
Cecil, you need help.
How often do you wash your ears, Mr. Moe?
At least once a month.
Well, we've given you a complete physical examination, your analysis, blood tests, x-rays. There's not a thing wrong with you that I can tell, Mr. Moe. But I am sending you to a brain specialist.
No lesions, no tumors, no evident atrophy, and no apparent abnormalities.
I can't do nothing with this.
Cecil, will you tell me once again why this reminds you of Myrna?
I don't know, it just does.
Yes, Dr. Krenwinkel. Doctor's ready to see you now. He's a real doozy.
Good morning, Mr. Moe. I'm Dr. Krenwinkel.
Good morning, Dr. Cranberry.
Oh,
What seems to be the problem, Cecil?
I don't know.
Are you married?
Yeah, I'm married. I got two boys.
How's your relationship with your wife?
Jean's been kind of distant lately. She won't laugh at any of my jokes anymore.
Tell me, did you hate your mother?
Of course I didn't hate my mother.
Well, how about your father?
No, I didn't hate him either.
Mr. Moore, I've worked with your type before. You're the suspicious type, always trying to be in control. Say, why do you sit like that? Is there anything you're keeping in?
No.
You happen to be in a prenatal position. What are you worried about?
I think I'm worried about paying you.
Mr. Moore, I don't think the medical profession can deal with you. I'm going to refer you to a clergyman who has had some limited success with antisocials like you.
Why did you pick this stuff up before you came?
It's not my fault. What about these bills, huh? Okay. All right. Hello, I'm Pastor Bigelow from the Church of the Free Spirit.
Hi, I'm Cecil Moe. This is my wife, Jean.
From what Dr. Krenwinkel tells me, I believe your problem is that you and your wife don't get out and socialize enough. Now, I'm going to suggest that you come out to our Wednesday night bingo. Our jackpot's larger than the American Legion. Do you like bingo, Mr. Moe?
I guess I played bingo before.
And on Friday nights, we have Jitterbug Dancing with a live band. You can get a babysitter and leave the kids at home.
I don't know if that's what I need.
Well, why don't you think about it? Here's my card. Call me anytime, all right?
Thanks.
Well, Pastor Bigelow, thank you for coming in, and we'll take a look at your card. Everything will be just fine.
There's no help for me anywhere.
Well, then I'll talk to you later, all right, Sharon? Sure. Bye-bye.
Jean, where'd you get that wreck?
I bought it.
For what?
So that I could get to work on my own.
So you could get to work on your own.
Dad?
That's great. I guess you don't need me anymore, huh?
Listen, Cecil, is it all right if we don't talk about this when the children are here?
Dad, can you take me for a ride in Mom's new car?
Later, okay? Daddy's really tired right now.
Okay.
Time to get up. You haven't been in work at all week.
I'm sick, Jean. I got the shapes again. Those doctors haven't done nothing for me.
Cecil, you've got to help yourself. Now, come on, you've got to get up and go to work. You know we need the money. My part-time job just isn't paying the bills.
It's not easy, Jean.
Well, it's not going to be any easier if we lose this house. Do you understand that the landlord called last night and he said that if we don't have some kind of rent to him by the end of the week, he's threatening to evict us? Oh, I don't understand you. Hello? Oh, hello, Mr. Stanley. Oh, yes, Cecil's here. Can you hang on for just a second, please?
Cecil, it's Mr. Stanley. I'm not going to lie for you. Now, take it.
Hi, Mr. Stanley.
I've been 3 jobs waiting for you this past week. What on earth has happened?
Well, I haven't felt too well lately.
I've got a man that offered to do those jobs for $40 a roof less than you've been doing. Now, are you coming out here or not?
Well, do you think I can have a couple days to think about it?
Later, bud.
Hello, Mr. Stanley. Hello.
What did you hang up, Cecil? How long did you think he was going to wait?
Look, Jean, stop worrying. You're always worrying about something. Look, I'm going to go out and get rid of these shakes. It should only take a drink or two, and I'll be all right. Then I'll go to work.
Jean, what's the matter?
You going to be home for supper this evening?
I'll be home. I promise.
You must be some kind of a nut.
I just got a lot of problems. I got 3 roofing jobs, and I should be at work right now. But I just can't bring myself to do it.
Hi, Cecil.
Hi, Harry. Give me a beer, would you?
How come you're not working today?
I don't know. I didn't feel like it.
You didn't work yesterday either, did you?
Just a half a day.
What's the problem?
I got a lot of things bothering me.
What's bothering you?
You're driving me crazy. I don't know, just things.
Hey, that's my furniture you guys are moving.
Not anymore.
Watch it, fella.
Hey, nobody moves my furniture without asking me first.
Cecil, you can't do anything about it now.
You bet I can.
It's gone, Cecil. Gone because you didn't pay a measly $10. And Mr. Ritter said last week we were going to lose this house if the rent's not paid up.
Don't worry, it will be.
Dad, could you help me with this?
Not now, Ronnie. Maybe tomorrow, okay?
Okay.
You know, Cecil, you might be able to put off paying the bills, but you can't put off your children much longer. I suppose you're going to go out again.
Yeah, how'd you guess? I was going to ask if I could borrow your car.
Hey, Mo, you got a $30 tab here. You paid off, we're gonna cut you off.
Yeah, I'll pay.
Oh, you don't seem to understand. I ain't running no non-profit organization here. I want that money now.
I don't have any money.
Hey, wait a minute.
I got a car. I'll sell it to you. It's gotta be worth something.
This car? $150.
$150?
Hey, you're getting a good deal, buddy. What do you want?
Can't you up that a little bit? I mean, I got a wife and kids to support, you know?
Hey, look, $150. I don't have time to stand here and talk to you. I got a lot of things to do. You want to sell a car or not?
Cecil? All right, Cecil, where's my car?
Shh, don't make such a noise.
Hey, I'll make noise if I want to. I want to know, where'd you park my car?
I sold it.
You sold my car?
I'll pay you back.
I'm just curious, how much did you sell it for?
$150.
$150? Do you realize that I paid $750 for it? How much money do you have left?
Where's the rest?
I'll pay you back, Jean, I promise.
$700. You know, I'm sick of your promises, and I'm sick of you. You know what this means, don't you? No car, no job. First they come and take our furniture, now they're going to come and take our house. What do you expect to do about this, Cecil? Have you thought about that?
I'll think of something. I always do. We'll pawn something.
Oh, save it.
Jean, wait. Jean. Come on in, Jean. What do you think? This is it. You like it? Got some big closets over here, plenty of room for all your stuff. Things really started to get bad. Gene and I were living in filth in the middle of a slum. There wasn't enough food or clothes for the kids, and a little bit of money I had coming in, I blew it on booze and gambling. That's not even the worst of it.
What was that, Cecil?
I'm ashamed to talk about it, Reverend. Ronnie got real sick. One night he started having convulsions.
Come on. I need you to help me now. Calm down, okay? Help me prop him up.
Can't.
Come on, just do it. I've got to go get some medicine now.
Medicine's not going to help. Did you get the medicine?
Hold on, I'm still looking.
Cecil, it's hot in here. Can you do something about the heat?
Okay.
Cecil?
Okay, Gene, I'm coming. I got a thing.
Where's the cough medicine?
I couldn't find it. I'll have to pawn something.
Pawn something like what?
Toaster.
The toaster? I need the toaster.
You don't need this toaster. The boy needs some medicine.
It's a funny thing, but I had every intention of using that $5 to buy Ron's medicine. That's the only reason I took Jean's necklace. But it was like I didn't have any control over what I was doing anymore.
I'll do what I can.
Did you tell her I was here?
I had to, Cece.
What'd she want anyway?
She wants you home. Ronnie's still sick. Cece, you've been here for 4 hours already. They need you.
Listen, Harry, I pay good money to drink at this bar, and I don't need your sermons.
I can't let you have any more, Cece.
God, bring me into this rotten world anyway.
Cecil, you need some help?
I can walk a few blocks.
Thank you.
So that's the story of my life. Next day, last night, really, that's when I stole the booze with Joel and brought it home to Gene. And do you think there was hope for me 10 years ago?
Oh, 10 years ago. Man, there's hope for you now.
Oh, no, not for me.
Cecil?
Oh, I don't want to hear that.
Don't you believe this is the Word of God?
Yeah, I believe it's the Word of God. I used to read it during the war when I was afraid I was going to get shot up by the Japanese. But I didn't understand, so I gave it up.
Well, Cecil, listen. The Bible says the natural man receiveth not the things of God.
Really?
Let me read to you from the 3rd chapter of the Gospel of John, where it says, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. Now, Nicodemus was a Pharisee. He was a religious man, but he didn't know God. Then Jesus goes on and says, verily, verily, I say unto you, except you be born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God.
Preacher, Tom, I don't understand what you're reading.
Listen, Cecil, let me paraphrase this.
Okay.
For God so loved Cecil Moe that he gave his only begotten son that person.
No, not me. He doesn't love me.
Why do you say that, Cecil?
If he loved me so much, then why did he take away my mom and my dad, and now my wife and kids?
Cecil, Jesus loves you. Christ died for you. He shed his blood for you. He wants you to repent. He wants you to call upon him, and he wants you to say, Lord, I'm a sinner.
Well, what do I have to do?
Repent of your sins and ask him to come into your heart and be your Savior. Would you like to kneel here right now? Let's pray and ask God to...
If I do that, is it going to bring back my wife and kids?
Cecil, I can't promise you that.
Is it going to bring back my business?
I can't even promise you that.
What can you promise me?
I can promise if you'll repent of your sins and call upon him, he'll give you eternal life and he'll deliver you from alcohol and he'll make a man out of you.
For good?
Forever.
Oh, how I'd like to be a man again. To look in the mirror and shave, and not want to cut my throat. It sounds too good to be true. What if I do this, whatever it is you say?
Repent of your sins and call upon Jesus as Lord and Savior. Would you like to do that right now, Cecil?
I trust Christ, and what if I still can't stop drinking? What then?
Cecil, if you really repent of your sins and trust Christ as Savior, and he doesn't change your life and deliver you, I'll throw that Bible away, and I'll never preach another sermon as long as I live.
You mean that?
I mean it, absolutely.
I want to trust Christ right now, Tom.
Let's pray.
Dear Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner. I can't begin to tell you how sorry I am for all the wrong that I've done. I've been a thief and a drunk and a liar and a bum for so long. I need you in my life now, Lord, so bad. My kids and my wife, they've all suffered so much. They've been so good and I've been so bad. I don't know.
Just ask him, Cecil, to come into your heart and be your Savior.
Dear Jesus, please come into my heart and make me a new man. Please, Jesus. Amen. I don't understand. Everything seems so beautiful.
You know, Cecil, the Bible said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things pass away. Behold, all things become as new.
Thank you, preacher.
God bless you, Cecil.
Would you let a drunk stranger come in your house at 4 o'clock in the morning?
Go upstairs and see Mommy, okay? Tell her I'll be home later.
I come home. You fix me some breakfast.
Wait, don't come home. I'm leaving here for good in half an hour.
Things will be different now. Last
Things
night.
Will be much different, Cecil.
Oh, please, Gene. Come on. I'm broke. I haven't got a dime.
You should have thought of that before you left.
You just let me come home and eat.
Cecil, there's nothing left to say.
No, you can't talk to me. I don't want to talk to you.
Something very special.
I don't care.
What if I said I was going to stop drinking?
I'd say that you were a stinking liar.
You have every right to say that. God saved me last night. I went to see a reverend. He showed me in the Bible where God forgave me my sins. I've changed.
Well, I haven't.
I've accepted Jesus Christ as the Lord of my life. I believe he died on the cross for me. I believe when he rose from the dead, he gave me a chance for a new life. I'm a changed man, Gene.
Must be out of my mind, but somehow I believe you.
Good morning, everybody. I got an announcement to make. Your dad's become a Christian.
What's a Christian, Daddy?
A Christian is somebody who trusts Jesus Christ, and last night I decided to do that. It means with God's help, I won't be drinking anymore. Well, let's do something we've never done before. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you for helping me find Jesus. And help others who need to find him be able to have the same experience that I did. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know you guys don't trust me, but you're gonna see a change in your old dad. I'm going downtown later and pick up a Bible, and I'm gonna get a haircut too.
Just gotta get drunk again.
Can I borrow $5, Gene? Come on, Gene. We're going to be late for church.
I'll be ready.
I really don't know what's bothering you this morning. We moved back up north and we're living in a nice neighborhood and I got more work than I know what to do with. And I'll tell you something else, Gene. I haven't touched a drop of liquor in all these months. That ought to make you happy, Gene.
Oh, I'm not. I'm not happy.
What's bothering you, Gene? I can tell something's the matter.
I don't know if I can take another one of these sermons on being born again.
So this morning, dear friends, we've come to the realization that God presents two roads to every man. And everyone has to make his choice as to the road that he will take. The one road leads to destruction. It's the broad and the popular road. The other is the narrow road that leads to a life. And we read, few there be that find it. Would to God that you would find that road this morning. May we pray together. Almighty and eternal God, our Father, we pray that thou wouldst lead that person who is on the border of turning his life, her life, over to thee, so that that person will find the narrow way that leads to life in Christ Jesus. In his name we pray. Amen.
I've been religious all my life. I go to church. I went to church before I could even talk. I even taught Sunday school for 11 years. You tell me, what else does God want?
He wants your heart, Gene. You know, Jesus died for everybody, not just bones like me. You know, we're all sinners in God's eyes. And God will forgive you if you accept him in your heart, just the way I did.
Are you going to that Winthrop Avenue job tomorrow?
Yeah, Stanley's got two roofs for me.
But Cecil, that neighborhood, there's so many bars there.
Don't worry about that, and the Lord will be with me and keep me out of that. Jesus loves you, Gene.
Sinned and come short of the glory of God. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
This letter to thank you for all that you've done for me. I have a new life in Jesus now. It's been 3 months since I've had a drink, and I know with God's help I'll never drink again. Gene still isn't a Christian yet, but I know someday my whole family will know Christ as I do. Sincerely, Cecil Moe.